there's really just the March of the Machines, Shards, and Gyrocopter's Ultimate when it comes down to AoE. And that is one of the things Slark is very susceptible to AoE spells, because when he gets low and pops that ultimate, one, you don't want to be taken down by AoE spells, but even some AoE spells, even if you're regening through them, it just keeps you low enough that you can't really regen up enough to continue, and you usually have to back yourself up from there.
10 seconds remaining.
Centaur going to be banned away by IG. Lion Gaming will take away the Tidehunter. Seeing as we've got all this nice, the March of the Machines, the Gyrocopter Ultimate. If you add in another AoE spell, the Ravage, actually makes for a pretty potent team fight and would harm the Slark pretty badly. He's not really a hero that wants to go BKB. And instead it's going to be Clockwork. Always strong versus other melee heroes. It's going to be a nice initiator for the Gyrocopter as well as the Tinker to be able to capitalize on. Meanwhile, this Centaur ban, apparently feeling that the Batrider, I guess, could be mid. We'd still need to see another offlaner.
10 seconds remaining.
Wonder how the Batrider does 1v1 up against Tinker. I can't imagine it is that I can't imagine it's that strong.
Reserve time.
Just because laser beats all. And he's going to pick it up the Storm Spirit for himself. And that is going to be one of best counters to Tinker. I have no idea why they would ban away the Centaur. It kind of felt like I kind of feel like just Storm Spirit was seen kind of obvious to some extent. I mean, Storm Spirit is being like this guy seems to only be drafted when he's up against the Tinker. Very rarely have we seen the Storm Spirit being picked up otherwise. So laning phase should be pretty straightforward, I believe. Offlane Batrider, offlane Clockwork, Tinker versus the Storm Spirit in the mid, and defensive tri-lanes for both sides. So we may see a very passive laning phase. There's going to be a lot of rotations from the Skywrath Mage and Vengeful Spirit, I think. I'm not sure about the Shadow Shaman Tuskar and how much they want to roam. These two supports want to pick up their level 2 at the very least. That way they have the nuke as well as the disable. And of course, Tuskar is only Tuskar if he has both shards and snowball. So you may see some really early rotations from the Skywrath Mage and Vengeful Spirit. Slightly later rotations from the Tuskar and Shadow Shaman. But that is the most action we're going to see, is the occasional smoke gank in the mid, I think.
Battle begins.
XTC. I'm going to run himself away from Chisbook. It's going to be an invis here for June. Nice little start for him. See if he can pick up a level 2 with that one. They do have counter wards. So that is something he may need to be careful of. Maybe caught by that. Slark is going to be our mid instead. Storm Spirit is going to be farming up the safe lane with the tri-lane around him. So Slark is definitely a lot less susceptible to the Tuskar rotations because of his pounce being used as an escape mechanism. I don't see him really being that strong of a laner versus the Tinker. But I think the priority is just making sure the Storm Spirit gets farmed, since he is going to be the main hero shutting down the Tinker going into some be forced back a bunch by Skywrath Mage, as they just use the other support to try and keep the Clockwork out as much as possible. And need to be careful with the Courier. Extra regen being brought in, Ferrari. Eventually, the Skywrath Mage will run out of mana, and Ferrari. So, whenever you're dealing with a Skywrath Mage, just bringing yourself extra regen is kind of all you need. Meanwhile, this bottom lane, XDT, playing quite aggressively with his Firefly. Now gonna right-click Chisbug a couple of times. Using that flying vision to his advantage, I suppose. surprise the Batrider. I think he's going to need to make the jungle work out for him. Just because this defensive tri-lane is a bit too strong, I would say. And the more conservative route of going into the jungle at level 2 would be, in my opinion, the best option for XTT. We'll see how he wants to run it. If he continues to stay here, though... Oh, hey, Stroon. And Snowball is going to come out. We don't quite see him, but he's actually put up on the cliff. Oh, Chissbug. What did you do? And XTT is now going to be able to run himself to the right side. Chissbug. They need this camp. He can't actually get down. You can't snowball to Ancients. Not these Ancients, anyway. So even if they had vision, he wouldn't be able to get it. So they need this camp to spawn. Ah, he brings a creep over. Nicely played by Chuan. That was an interesting little pair of events. At least they force the Batrider back. XE's going to try and put some pressure on Ferrari. I don't know about diving that one, though. A bit risky. And he will have a little bit of return fire being put on him. Phase boot's going to be up for the gyrocopter, and that'll give him a lot more laning presence against the Batrider. Still have yet to see these supports heavily rotate in. Yeah, XTD now trying to just go ahead and jungle, probably for the best. He kept the supports down in the bottom lane, though, for a good 3 minutes, which is nice for XZ, since you know how much the Tuskar loves being able to roam. And the Shadow Shaman isn't bad at it either. Here comes your first gank. It's going to be from the Vengeful Spirit and Batrider combination. Not quite what you expect, but they've been both off-map for quite some time. Ferrari, seeing that secondary support up in the top lane, is going to be lulled into a false sense of security here. And now, with the March of the Machines already going out, though, XTT, Icicle Shard's not going to be hitting. Snowball, not going to collide with Super either. Rocket's going to come in, but that wouldn't even kill him. I don't think. Might have. It would have been really close. 120 damage reduced by 25%. That's what, 30 damage? It would have done 90 damage, and he did 75 health, 76 health. Yeah, it would have killed him, actually. But yeah, the danger of the March of the Machines, if they'd just been able to catch him out before he could have, before March of the Machines went out, would have been a quick and easy kill for them, but unfortunately, that is not going to be the case. XTT, meanwhile, seeing the Shadow Shaman run in the bottom lane. This is a problem, though, with Phase Boots Gyrocopter. You can very easily just chase the Batrider out. In fact, Luo, still trying to chase him down, just needs one more right click and isn't going to be able to get him. Surprised he's not continuing. Oh, the flat cannon shots. He still had some vision. Because these trees were cut down, he still had vision of the Batrider coming over. I was surprised. Luo was like, why is he going for creeps here? But Luo, too smart for me, man. Uses the flat cannon expertly. And does get the first button in the lane. So already he was free farming. But now he just got a solo kill on a Batrider. And is able to pick up that first blood as well. Perfect. We may try reconnect here. Oh, Storm Spirit getting caught here in the top lane. As a aggro try of sorts is going to come out. We may need to try and reconnect here as it's lags a little obnoxious. So now and we also have a D2CL match, Navi US versus Root. So, yep, only two kills on the board so far.
Denied.
Tinker is now level 6. Slark is a bit under-farmed. Probably just because of the laser spam, but still.
Is under attack. Much appreciated.
Looks like they want to go again. Snowball with the clockwork. They're going to go for the Storm Spirit. They're going to try and trap him in with the cogs and the icicle shards, both being used. Good enough. And Chuan will be popped real quickly. Now they're going to go for the supports. Farther back, Super is already so low. The Sigil is slowing him down. Nice little body blocking by 5400. And nicely played with the cogs, just doing that extra bit of burnout damage. And if he just had the regen mana for it, he would actually be able to finish off the Vengeful Spirit with the rocket. Doesn't look like he'll be able to get it up in time, though. Mid lane, Friar's going to be caught out by XZ. And going for the dive here. It's a risky one. Body blocking by Chuan. Last little dark pack damage. Oh, he delayed it. He didn't stay in range of Ferrari. Now the nuke comes out from the Sky Earth Mage. Still not enough damage. Right clicking and everything, not enough. As the bottle is enough to keep our Tinker alive. And instead it's going to be the Sky Earth Mage who dies. XZ still playing super aggressive in the mid lane, though. As he continues to search for those extra pickoffs now. Luo has phase boots, ring of a kill, as well as 1,200 gold on him. Him as well as the Tinker at the top two CS on the board. So LAI Gaming definitely suffering in the laning phase so far. Especially with Storm Spirit dying twice already thanks to these ganks from the two supports. Chisbug finds himself a haste rune.
Tally-ho!
And where is he going to go with it? Looks like they may try and go for a bit of a push here. No, already the lane's being brought back by Chuan. They can go for an early push if they want to. A gyrocopter with that fast set of phase boots as well as the Ring of Aquila. In fact, Chuan, yeah, that's exactly what they want to do. Well, I think so anyway. Chuan didn't have trees to eat through, so he couldn't go for a double pull, but he still went for a single pull anyway, which will push out the lane. Now, Sprinty, they're going for a gank on Ferrari. Stun, magic missile stun. That's going to be good enough for Ferrari to get picked off. Nicely played by LAI Gaming. They need those kind of consistent pickoffs. Now, Super is going to try and teleport himself away. The snowball will put a stop to that one. And they get a return kill, but it's still worth it for LAI Gaming. Picking off that Tinker. Storm Spirit, meanwhile, is while he has been ganked up a few times, he is going to be building still into a relatively fast Orchid. Radiant. Already have the trance and double rope on the Jaws. It's going to be another, like, 5 to 10 minutes. Before he can actually manage to pick that one up. Meanwhile, here comes the push in the bottom lane. It's flat cannon shots. Okay, maybe not. Really thought they were going to commit to that one a bit more. Apparently not. June has picked up his level 6 and is going to look for another pick off. Storm Spirit, though, is obviously not the hero he can kill.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
And double damage now for Tuskar. Another smoke up for Super. And maybe he'll join the Slark again, see if they can go for another kill on the Tinker. Again, just constantly ganking up the Tinker is the best way for you to be able to deal with him. The longer you slow down the blink, the boots of travel, the longer you delay everything else. Boots of travel are effectively the farming item for the Tinker. So.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
And they're going to run into Chisbug here. They're going to try and pop him instead of going for the Tinker, which is fine. Free kill is still a free kill. And they didn't have to blow a smoke for it either. Hookshot is going to grab XZ here. I'm not sure how they're going to be able to get this kill. He's going to jump onto Luo here. The stun also going down. Super is going to be extra slowed down by the Sigil. Looks like he'll be picked up by the gyrocopter runs forward.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Do it with flair.
At Sigil just being so strong, even after the Tuskar is dead, still ensuring a kill on a support like that. Early BKB is going to be picked up by Luo. They now use the Serpent Wards to be able to claim this tier 1 tower. And June is going to be taking it for the team. LAI gaming, not going to be able to afford any kind of response here, and the tier 1 tower will fall.
Structures are fortified.
Meanwhile, the side lanes are being pushed out. XTT trying to farm up his blink dagger for now. And looks like we may be seeing June going for a pickoff here in the top lane. XTT has just been hit. Rocket goes down. He lands a hookshot and got him. Well played by June.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Do it with flair.
About these two heroes is that LAI keeps them together. They're staying together for the most part and just trying to find kills, but with this they are losing towers. Another tier one falls to Lu, and now his BKB is done. It's gonna fly out and they can absolutely fight with that. June actually has hookshot up in 20. Not that much mana, but with a bracer and with power treads, I don't know if you're really in that big of a position where you absolutely need it. Chizbug is actually still almost level 5, and that's it. He's actually at level 4. So this is the one issue, is that they don't have levels on their Tusk, which is a problem. A hero that doesn't necessarily require that many levels, but I think it's still important to have. Lua walks through with an invis rune, they have no detection, so... nothing they can really do about that. They get caught out of position. They got a bots in, and Luo is looking to go, but XE is just like, well, I mean, I spotted this out. We have plenty of vision here, so try to take the bottom tower. Again, this is the problem, though. XTT can't do anything until he gets his blink. He's getting close. Meanwhile, XE is going to try to pounce maybe on Luo, who is a BKB. XE is going to cut the creep wave. They know that he's here now. This is a pretty smart play from him. We've seen him do this multiple times. And it's just so annoying, and this is what I like about IG. They just don't waste any time. They go right down bottom, or at least for Luo, and they'll just stop this kind of silly business, essentially. This creep wave is still falling. XZ. That's got to be infuriating, I think, if you're Invictus Gaming, but they do have the Tinker, so this is to no fault of their own. Blink Dagger now done for XTT, so this is their timing. 14 minutes in. Homing Missile is going to go on super. There is the Firefly. Luo does have his BKB, but he doesn't want to get Blink Lassoed, which is certainly a prime target for them. Mystic Flare is going to go as well, and he cannot get the BKB off. And they know that he has the blood now. Flare is going to go through, or rather the heat-seeking missiles, and they lose Luo, but I don't think he's ever in that position where he gets caught out again. Now that they know they have the Blink Dagger on the Batrider, I don't think that should happen anymore. They'll try to put pressure here on this tier 1 tower bottom. There's the Serpent Ward. Super is going to get Ice Sharded in.
And Snowball holds him up even longer. Chizbug doesn't quite have his level 6, but it doesn't matter. With the extra bit of rocket damage they have, they'll be able to claim the kill. And the tier 1 tower. So June is going to pick that one up. Wonder what he's going to go for. Looks like a 4 staff.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Little bit surprised the 4 staff. I almost kind of think this is a Blade Melt game, personally. Just Slark and Storm Spirit. Neither one are BKB heroes. And what a bad timing. XE with a double damage rune is going to run right into Luo. He's not going to be able to commit to the kill. Or will he? Maybe. I thought he was going to try and go back in, possibly, with his ultimate and that double damage. But he didn't want to risk overextending himself. Instead, he just ensures that the Storm Spirit was able to get that tower, which gets him that much closer to the Orchid that will be designed to shut down the Tinker. Speaking of the Tinker, Ferrari's just about to pick up his Blink Dagger. So Blink, boots of travel by 16 minutes in. Pretty good timing. And Slark does, in fact, find the kill onto the Clockwork. So nice pickup on him. Slark is definitely doing a lot of work so far in this game. LAI Gaming are pretty well designed. I mean, the Slark can handle the Gyrocopter, I think, pretty well. And then the Storm Spirit is a big counter to the Tinker. So I think all LAI Gaming have to do is just consistently go for these kills. The problem is they don't have much pushing power. I think that's going to be their biggest issue. Once again, we have an invis rune being picked up by XZ. which is scouting things out perfectly. We're going to see the Skywrath Mage go ahead and drop the ultimate on Ferrari from long range. That'll be enough for XD to be able to get a killing spree. Bottom lane, XDD jumping himself away. June, already having used the hook shot in an earlier fight, won't be able to close the gap. They used the Serpent Wards here just to be able to defend this Tier 1 tower in the bottom lane. A bit surprised because with that pickoff on the Tinker, I don't think there's any way they can keep this Tier 1 tower alive. LAI Gaming are just going to go for the dive here. XZ jumps in with his Blink Dagger. He's going to pop Chuan first. Now June gets off a pretty good hook shot. Still going to be caught out. Luo comes in with his BKB. They're going to try to get themselves away from him. XCD actually managed to blow all of his mana. Is going to be caught up by Luo. Rocket Barrage going off. Not quite enough. Now XCT will actually lasso Luo up and drag him to the side here. They already finished off the clockwork with a Skywrath Mage. And it might just be that LAI Gaming can get themselves the rest of them. Now Storm Spirit has already died to Ferrari. Bounce back. Flame Break. Super. Rocket's going to come in and does hit him just before he can teleport himself away. XZ comes back in, going for a Ferrari kill, and they may have gotten a lot there, but oh, the pounce completely whiffing on Ferrari. Really thought he could have gone for that kill, but again, XZ playing it a lot more conservatively than I would have expected. I mean, if they had gotten the Tinker kill, it would have to some extent been worth it, but I think now after a teamfight like that, IG, that, I mean, they've got so much tower control. The fact that they actually kept this Tier 1 tower alive, it, to me, is really important. Because LAI Gaming are on a timer, I believe. The Tinker is just so strong going into late game. So without these tower kills, I think they're just going to be stalled out too much by March of the Machines. Like, I legitimately think that them failing to claim that Tier 1 tower in the bottom lane is a big, big deal, because they're going to stall out for another 5 minutes just trying to claim that Tier 1.
Where's the party?
Luo pops a BKB in response to XDD. Diving in pretty deep. What a hook shot, though. He's going to be able to lock in at least 5,400. He's going to lose his life in return. Skywrath Mage actually managed to catch out XDD with the Hex, and they'll finish him off as well. IG just snowballing through everybody is now going to move up to this Tier 2 tower. And the Tinker will just be able to force them back with the Rocket Spam and the March of the Machines, and IG will just slap it down. They already used the Mass Serpent Wards, but they can just... That's fine. Just right-click it as a team. Now, it looks like LAI Gaming are still going to try and go for the fight here. We have XZ waiting to set up his Blink Dagger initiation. And it looks like they're actually going to back up on the side of IG. June goes into the middle lane to train farm. He's going to be going for a mech on his team. They don't really have a mech core, and even the supports aren't really mech heroes in general either. So I guess it does make sense to a certain extent. LAI Gaming smoked up. We have the two supports joining the offlane Batrider for a very important pickoff. Oh, BKB activated by Luo. This means they won't be able to get that one kill. They may be able to get Chuan instead. Skywrath Mage finishes them off. Chizbug gets hit by the stun. Oh, nice jump in there from June. Stops the teleport away by 5,400. And they'll get both the supports in the process. Luo did have to use another BKB charge for that one, but... well worth it as they trade one for two. And Gyrocopter can now invest into some big time item. I'm going to presume it's going to be Butterfly for the Gyrocopter, because the evasion chance will really help him versus the Slark as we start going into the mid to late game. I think that's a big bit better than the just raw damage of MKB or something like that. Nice control here by IG. They've been laying down a lot of counter wards. Really limiting the vision of LAI Gaming so far. And there goes that Dagon for Ferrari. who's able to chase away Slark. He should be building into a Scotty next, I assume. Though I have yet to see XE play the Slark, I think so. Who knows? Maybe he has a different build in mind. In the Western scene, though, it's primarily building into a Scotty. And IG, all they have to do is just stall this game out. I mean, they can take some towers if they see opportunities, but there's no pressure on them to really use these Serpent Wards. Like, they just took some early tier 1 towers, got that faster Boots of Travel. That's all they needed to do. Sneaky little path from LAI Gaming. It's the Underground Railroad. The Underground Railroad was on fire. And Harriet Tubman was a bat.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
A bat rider.
Flare's here.
And here it goes. Another tier 2 gonna fall. And LAI Gaming, we're really banking on somebody teleporting to this top lane, most notably the Tinker.
But is under attack.
Instead, IG are just going to be committing to taking this tier 2 tower and calling it good.
Radiant structures are fortified. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
They knew all along what was going to happen. Rocket reveals the path on the side, and no one's going to teleport to this top lane. Not without massive amounts of support. And that's why Ferrari is going to teleport to tier 3 first, and then move forward. June's going to be the first one on the front lines. And now he's going to actually jump in for XCD. They're actually going to be able to pop him before he can do anything there. 5,400. Teleport himself away. They almost got the tier 2. That's the upside for LAI Gaming. The downside is they wasted so much time with all those heroes there. Looks like a Manta may be picked up by Luo instead of a Scotty. So that's a bit interesting. Really thought he was going to go for a Butterfly. It makes, I think, a lot of sense, this game. Dagger level 2 with the Ghost Scepter now for Ferrari. Ghost Scepter was definitely necessary. A lot of times when Tinkers invest in the Ghosts, though, they go for the full Ethereal Blade.
Do it with flair.
Which can be a very hefty investment. I mean, 3,300 gold, that's at least 2 levels of Dagon you could add. First, Skywrath Mage Ultimate being dropped there and completely whiffed. TD actually brings the hero back, and now Skywrath Mage loses its life. Ferrari also going to look to pop him. XTT not going to be held up by those shards. XZ now is going to be forced to try and get himself away with his ultimate. As the missile comes, but it's still going to be a tier 2 for IG, and very good control play by them. As I honestly think that this game is pretty much over from here. Like, LAI Gaming just could not seem to find the openings to be able to catch out the Tinker enough. And now that this Tinker has gotten into a pretty strong mid-game force, going to be a big contributing factor to many of these team fights. LAI Gaming don't have an obvious advantage in any part of the game now. Like, it was supposed to be their pick-off potential and their team fight. But I think that one of their biggest problems was just lacking, really just lacking enough stuns. Lacking enough initiation? Maybe it was pushing power? I'm not sure. Like, they had good initiation between the Slark, Blink Dagger, Batrider. Like, all three of their cores are initiators. So I'm not sure if they just didn't take enough opportunities to jump. Or maybe it was, again, falling back into the pushing problem. Either way, there is a distinct lack of tower kills for the side of LAI Gaming as this top tier 1 is the only tower that's gone down, and they're about to lose their slug. Slark, who was building into Ascani, almost had it finished up too. But it's now going to be significantly delayed by that death. Gem on the Batrider. Super nice little sneaky ward. Just gonna teleport himself away.
Do it with flair.
I suppose the Mantua is probably because of the Orchid from the Storm Spirit. And this does make sense, but he already kind of had the BKB. I really felt Butterfly would have been a nice addition, especially since Storm Spirit, as well as Slark, are heavily dependent on their right clicks to be able to, for their damage, so. Theria Blade finished up by Ferrari. So that recent kill on the Slark gives him enough for his full E-Blade plus the Dagon 2. And now so much burst damage. LAI Gaming really need to be able to take a, Ferrari just popped the Storm Spirit. Yep. That just happened.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant
tier 2 falls in the top lane, and the middle tier 1 is still going to be kept alive. They still had a glyph. And tier 1 takes a minimal amount of damage. Still very healthy. LAI Gaming, they just gotta like backdoor some of these towers or something. I mean, they're seriously being crippled by all the lack of gold. Almost a 14,000 gold lead for IG. Experience not nearly as much, in fact, for a serious part of the game. LAI Gaming were actually ahead in experience. Link Dagger for Chisbug. Blink Dagger for Tuskar, Blink Dagger for Chuan, and soon to be an Aghanim, since he is just one component away. Four Staff Mech for the Clockwork, and XCD. Well, he definitely needs a BKB, as well as a Slark and his Scotty. Speaking of. There's that Iskani, but again, I don't see how it's going to be able to do much. I mean, they're just stalling out this game, but it's a Tinker and Gyrocopter going into the late game with some pretty damn good backup. Not saying that their late game is impossible to beat. Just that it's impossible to beat with this kind of gold lead. Four-man smoke from IEG is they're going to rotate, see if they can get a pickoff, and if they do, if it's a good enough pickoff, they'll turn it into a tier 3 tower push. If not, they can always back up and do Roshan. Skywrath Mage, not the most high-value pickoff in the world.
Tower has fallen.
So they're going to continue to move up to the top lane. Storm Spirit's already blown some of his mana, gets heads up, and bursts it down. Now Super's going to be up next. And that's two kills. Yeah, I think that's enough for them to be able to push uphill. They rotate straight to mid. Yep, there goes IG. They've got Mass Serpent Wards. Not quite the Aghanim's upgrade. So it's a bit unfortunate, but at least it's level 2 Mass Serpent Wards.
Dire structures are fortified.
And LAI Gaming, what did they get in return? A tier 1 tower. They have to defend now. They couldn't even go for a tier 2. That's how sad that is. XE is going to be jumping in up against the Manta illusions of the Gyrocopter. And he clears through some of them, but really just not enough. Now the tier 3 tower will fall. Sigil, Cogs, and the Mass Serpent Wards all being used as some zoning factor. Initiation there from XDT instantly gets hexed up. BKB activated by Luo. The swap goes out as well. Beautiful gyrocopter ultimate that's going to be able to land on all three of them and get a potential double for Luo. Farther down, we do have the Slark who tries to go in, almost getting popped. One more hit. And Luo gets a triple kill now with that one. Moves on to the melee racks. Buyback by him. But it's the only thing they had. IG, they're not in any hurry to be able to finish off this melee rack, so they didn't really care. They forced a buyback. The Slark is really shut down now. They did lose their whole entire supporting cast. The important, though, thing is that IG kept both the gyrocopter as well as the Tinker alive. And that just means higher level Dagons, possibly Shivas or Scythe, or what have you. And this time, fairly confident. Butterfly, seriously, for Luo, seriously. BKB gonna be activated, Chissbug comes in, trying to save his carry. And now with the hookshot, follow up Snowball, Icicle Shards. A leap away there from XZ, now the Snowball comes out. But the Blink Dagger is enough distance, Walrus Punch is gonna hold him up for another second, pounce away. XZ just has so much mobility with that Blink Dagger, he will be able to get himself out. And IG, since they already rotated so many heroes into the bottom lane, why not go for a bottom lane push with this fresh Aghanim Scepter upgrade for the Shadow Shot? Tinker is almost doubled the net worth of the highest net worth on LAI Gaming, which is the Storm Spirit, sitting at 11,000. Gyrocopter not too shabby either, as he's sitting at 17,000, another 6,000 gold ahead. Illusion. Chuan jumps in up against Super. XDT is going to bring him back. They're trying to pop him real quickly. There goes Chuan. There goes their pushing power, most importantly. XDT forced to pop his BKB. Luo is still doing a lot of damage with his flat cannon shots, as he has most recently picked up the Eagle Song. And that means LAI Gaming actually get a really favorable engagement there. They got to pick off on probably the most important support right now. If they can't actually, like, pop the gyrocopter or pop the Tinker, Shadow Shaman is their next best target. Aghanim Scepter going to be the next item here for June. We do have IG. What's Ferrari going to be building into? It's a Bloodstone, it's a Shiva, it's a Scythe. Homing in. I would kind of like to see... I don't know what I would like to see, actually. Because I don't think he needs Shivas, thanks to his Ethereal Blade. Scythe of Ice is nice. It's pretty expensive. Good awareness there by Ferrari. Faking out a teleport to the top lane and... just casually dagging in creeps. Another smoke up here from the side of IG. They're going to look for, again, just like they did when they pushed in the middle lane. If they can get a good pick off, they'll immediately turn it into a push. And this time, possibly end the game. At least get themselves that melee racks that they have been trying to claim. Running in, finding two supports. Kind of perfect for them. Snowball's going to be the first one. Hookshot misses completely there. Juan's going to commit the Serpent Wards here just to win this fight, as it's going to be perfectly acceptable, as they're going to get four kills off of it. Ultra kill godlike Luo. And say hello, middle lane. XZ being chased down by Ferrari, even pops his ultimate just to teleport back home. They have no buybacks on the side of LAI Gaming. Zero. Zip. None. Nada. And that means melee racks will fall. Probably the bottom tier 3 and possibly second set of racks. As LAI Gaming are going to hold on for one last team fight. Now they go top instead.
Dire's structures are fortified. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Glyph activated. They've got 8 seconds until the Storm Spirit's back up. They have to have one hell of a doozy of a team fight for the side of LAI Gaming if they want back into this game. Already losing their melee racks. IG sticking around long enough to finish off the range racks as well. Storm Spirit is up. Swap goes down onto the roof. He's going to pop his BKB. Super's going to lose his life immediately as the Digger just goes ahead and eliminates him real quickly. LAI Gaming still not really initiating. Now they're going to try and go for the fight. Already finishing off two heroes here. It's Chisbug's going to be next up. Rari running around with his BKB. And the Storm Spirit can't do anything to stop him. And there goes GG, finally called by LAI Gaming in game number one of the loser bracket finals of the Sina Cup. So very well played by IG, LAI Gaming. I don't think they had the wrong idea when it came to the draft, but they seemed like there was something missing. They either needed to play that a lot more aggressively, or they needed some extra pushing power, as towers seemed to be the most significant factor for them. And Ferrari still managed to get himself a Boots of Travel plus Blink Dagger by 16 minutes in. That's good timing for a Tinker. So they really just did not shut him down hard enough, and their lack of push ended up costing them because they just could not finish off any of those towers. So they needed to either more aggressively shut down the Tinker and find those openings, or go for a different kind of drop. So we'll see what they do in game number two. I would say just don't give up the Tinker to Ferrari because he played that pretty damn well. But we'll see what happens in just a short little break.